Former Elizabethtown police officer dies after his home catches fire over the weekend.
It happened early Sunday morning on Sky Blue Avenue in E-Town. WLKY's Drew Douglas spoke to investigators and the victim's former co-workers. He joins us now live, Drew.
Vicki, Michael McClure retired from the Elizabethtown Police Department 7 years ago. Investigators say an electrical problem in his attic started the fire.
When we got there, there was smoke, heavy smoke coming from the house. There was flames, heavy flames coming out of pretty much every window except two.
Caution tape still surrounds the home where Michael McClure lived alone. Chief Fire Investigator Jeremy Goodman says the blaze started near the ceiling fan of the 52-year-old's living room.
We're unsure if the actual ceiling fan locked up or a bearing went out in the ceiling fan or some type of malfunction in the ceiling fan. Until we get it back from the lab, we won't know for sure exactly what malfunctioned in the ceiling fan or if it was the wiring in the ceiling fan.
Lieutenant Goodman says McClure was found in the hallway and it appeared he was trying to crawl out. The tragic news spread fast to some of his old co-workers at the Elizabethtown Police Department. Deputy Chief of Administration Troy Dye says the unit of 49 officers is still small enough to have the feel of a family.
It's tough for all of us to hear. There are a lot of new officers here that weren't familiar with Mike. But those of us that have been around a long time have been talking about it today, and it's pretty tough to deal with.
McClure started as a dispatcher in 1987, then spent 19 years on the force before retiring in 2006. Much of that time was spent working with Dye, who tells WLKY McClure got along with everyone and often went above and beyond as an officer.
And he always tried to do what was best for the agency and try to find a peaceful resolution to anything that he was involved with.
It's unclear if McClure died from smoke inhalation or burns from the flames. Goodman says he's still awaiting the results of an autopsy. I'm Drew Douglas, WLKY News.